Today I'm going to talk about catastrophizing when you have pelvic pain and what I believe is the solution for it. Conventional cognitive therapy that's used in contemporary psychotherapy to deal with catastrophizing in general has had some degree of success in dealing with anxiety, depression, and catastrophizing. Using cognitive therapy with pelvic pain patients when they are afraid that their pelvic pain will never go away, in my experience, is not helpful. While medications can temporarily help calm down the nervous system and reduce the tendency to catastrophize, ultimately, drugs and cognitive therapy both are not particularly helpful in dealing with the catastrophizing that occurs with those who are dealing with chronic pelvic pain. Chronic pelvic pain is an ongoing, intimate, gnawing discomfort that in most of the patients I have seen stops any semblance of quality of life. Catastrophic thinking offers nothing to the pelvic pain patient except suffering, and yet without knowing any real alternative, there's very little that most professional help can offer a pelvic pain patient who is catastrophizing. There is an answer to it, however. In my experience, the answer to catastrophic thinking for the pelvic pain patient does not reside in a psychotherapeutic method. I say this having been a psychologist for over 40 years. The answer lies in the patient's ability to reduce or stop his or her own pain. When patients can do physical therapy self-treatment and a relaxation protocol skillfully that calms down the nervous system and actually reduces the pain, and these are the central methods of the Wise-Anderson protocol, catastrophic thinking and pelvic pain tends to stop. It's the empowerment of being able to routinely reduce or stop your own symptoms yourself that is the real solution to the catastrophic thinking for those struggling with chronic pelvic pain.